Good morning. We begin with accounting for depreciation. So, what is depreciation? Reduction in the value of asset. Reduction in the value of asset. Why this reduction happens? Which may be a land, building or machinery or furniture. Reduction in the value of asset. Why this reduction happened? Due to usage or due to abnormal usage? Wear and tear that is caused by frictions. Okay, then this may be due to time factor. For example, you buy an asset, don't use it for some time. Can you sell the asset for the same value? You buy a car or a bike, okay, don't use it for about 5 years. Can you sell and get the same value? No, maybe arising because of time, because of technology. Okay, we call it as obsolescence. Clear? When new technology comes, though the old technology machine or asset is being used, it will have no value. It will have no value because of technology also the depreciation will arise. So if you look at it arises because of usage, abnormal usage, wear and tear and frictions, and it may happen due to technology. Okay. So if you look at this, why do we provide depreciation? Why do we provide depreciation? For the purpose of income determination, we use the asset, there is a value change, you charge it in income. Then, okay, this is claimed as an expense. Okay, then it is allocation of cost of asset over the period of benefit. For example, you spend 20 lakhs in purchasing a machinery. And the life is 5 years. So each year you will write off 4 lakhs, 4 lakhs, 4 lakhs, 4 lakhs like that. It is like I spent 20 lakhs. The benefit is enjoyed over a period of 5 years. So I claim 4 lakhs as an expense. So I allocate the cost of the asset based on the period of benefit for the purpose of income determination again. Accrual basis accounting can be done by allocating the cost of the asset over the period of benefit. That is another reason. Depreciation is a non-cash expense. It is a secret reserve. Okay, depreciation, we don't spend money. It's a non-cash item. It can be taken as a reserve for replacement of asset also, or it can be viewed as a reserve for replacement of asset. Okay, so this is a reserve. We don't show it in liability side. Okay, we call it as provision for depreciation. We adjust it with asset value. We adjust it with which value? Asset value. So that is another reason for claiming depreciation. Then to show our true and fair view. Simple. When you don't depreciate machinery and record them at cost in the balance sheet, it is not showing true and fair view. So fair view is nothing but cost of the asset minus depreciation. That is the value which you can get if you sell the asset. Okay. Tax benefits. Depreciation can be claimed as an expense for tax purposes. So you claim depreciation. You do not want to claim depreciation. Okay, you lose tax benefit. You claim depreciation. That amount, by that amount, that taxable income reduces. So you enjoy tax benefit, you claim depreciation. So these are the reasons for claiming which one? Depreciation. Which method we are going to use? Mainly there are two methods. One is called a straight line method. Okay. Otherwise called as original cost method. Depreciation will be always prorated on the cost of the asset. That is called as what? Straight line method. Other method is called as WDV method. Return on value method. Okay. So, how depreciation is calculated? Understand, we can make a note of all these things. I request you to make a note of all these things. It's like running notes, you have to take it. How, though it is an online class or a recorded class, You should take it like a regular class only. You must write notes. You must write notes. Don't think that this is available anytime I can revise. No, it's not possible to revise 100 hours of lecture before exam. But your own notes you can go through in 1 or 2 hours. Okay. So how depreciation is calculated? On the cost of the asset. Always depreciation is calculated on the cost of the asset. This is calculated on the opening book value. That is the value at the beginning of each year, the depreciation is calculated. If you look at the amount of depreciation, okay, same for all years, okay, it will reduce, which means it is calculated on the opening book value of the asset. When you charge depreciation, the depreciation will keep going down, okay. But in straight line method, the amount of depreciation is going to be what? Same for all the years, right? Now, which method is good? Is it SLM or WDV method? Income tax or company law recognizes WDV method and not straight line method. The reason is very simple. Probably I'll explain through an example so that you will understand better. Okay, let me to take depreciation of the asset along with repair expenses. Depreciation of the asset along with which one? Repair expenses. Okay, let's assume an asset was purchased. Cost of the asset was, let's assume it is 5 lakhs. Cost of the asset is 5 lakhs. Okay, repair expenses for first year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year. Let us assume life of the asset is 5 years. So when you let us assume there is no scrap value, when you go for straight line method, 55 lakh divided by 5 years, 5 lakh divided by 5 years, like that we will provide. Let us assume repairs for the first year, it comes to 0 because it is the first year of the usage of asset. Normally no depreciation will come, or it will be covered by guarantee and warranty, no depreciation. Second year, gradually the depreciation increases. As the life goes up, you require more maintenance, 20,000, third year 36,000, fourth year 50,000, fifth year 60,000, like that. So that repairs goes up when the age of the asset increases, because old asset requires more depreciation, more maintenance, repairs and maintenance. It will cause more wear and tear. Now, let us assume if you are following SLM, 5 lakh by 5 years, or you can say 5 lakh into 20%. If there is no scrap value, 5 lakh divided by 20%. What will be the depreciation amount? 1 lakh. And the depreciation amount will be same. First year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year, depreciation amount will be what? Same. Under straight line method, depreciation is always calculated on the cost. 5 lakh into 20%, 1 lakh, it is same. Okay, if we add depreciation plus repairs, it will give us total charge because of the asset. Depreciation 1 lakh, repair 0, totally 1 lakh. Second year, depreciation 1 lakh, repairs 20,000, 1 lakh 20,000, like that. You can see the total charge that is claimed because of the asset or in lieu of asset is more, or it is increasing year by year. Okay. So if you look at along with the repairs, the total charge that is claimed with the asset is increasing year by year. Okay, let us go for WDV method. 20%, let us assume 20%. 5 lakh into 20%. First year it will not make any difference. Second year, 5 lakh minus 1 lakh. 4 lakh into 20%. 80,000. Third year, 5 lakh minus 1 lakh minus 80,000. It will be 3 lakh 20,000 into 20%. Okay. WDV method, the depreciation charged for the earlier year, it will be adjusted. Book value will be 5 lakhs minus 1 lakh 80, 3 lakh 20 into 20%, 64,000. Then 3 lakh 20,000 minus 64,000 into 20%. That is 2,56,000 into 20%, 5,12,000. 2,56,000 minus 51,200 into 20%, 40,960. Like that, depreciation will go down. Let us assume it is the same asset. When we follow WDV method, repairs, method of depreciation will not decide repairs. Repairs of the asset is going to be same. 0 first year, second year 20,000, 36,000, 50,000, 60,000. Same asset, okay? If you add, you will get the total. You can see 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh, some 1 lakh 2,000, 1 lakh 960. The total amount claimed under WDV method, it results in uniform charge. What do you mean the uniform charge? If you take repairs with depreciation, the total amount claimed in the P&L account or total amount charged in the revenue will become uniform when you follow which method? WDV method. When you follow straight line method, first year it will be low, second year because of repairs, the amount charged in the P&L account goes up. Okay, so under SLM, the amount charged in the P&L account goes up. So which method results in uniform charge? WDV method results in uniform charge. But straight line method, depreciation only will be uniform. If you take it along with repairs, the total amount charged in P&L account will keep on increasing. That's why income tax law or company law recommended WDV method. It results in uniform charge. Some 1,000, 2,000 difference will be there, but it results in overall a uniform charge over a period of asset. Please take this example. Cost of the asset 5 lakhs, life 5 years, rate of depreciation 20%. When we go by SLM, depreciation is uniform. When we add repairs, the total charge claimed increases every year. Under WDV method, when we add depreciation, the total charge becomes what? Uniform. So that's why WDV method is recommended. Apart from this, there are other methods also. We'll take up an example from your study material and we'll discuss. There are other examples also, like production units method, things like that. We'll take up from your study material and we'll discuss. So these are the two widely used material, where there is methods, straight line method and which method? WDV method. Okay. So we'll go for learning journal entry next. Hope you copied this, otherwise pass and copy. We'll go for journal entry. This is WDV depreciation. Okay. Mention it as WDV depreciation. This is straight line method depreciation. We learned journal entries. So there are two methods of recording depreciation. One is normal method or provision for depreciation method. Simple. In normal method, depreciation is directly charged to the asset. The second method, depreciation is recorded in provision for depreciation account. First method, depreciation is charged directly to the asset. Second method, depreciation is recorded in which one? Provision for depreciation account. Like that, there are two methods. One is direct charge, other one is recording in provision for depreciation account. So first transaction, when an asset is purchased, let it be any method, journal entry is going to be same. Asset account debtor to cash or bank. Clear? Asset account debtor to cash or bank account. Same entry will come in the next method also. Asset account debtor to cash or bank account. Okay, number two, when depreciation is charged under direct method, depreciation is directly charged to the asset. The second method, depreciation account debtor, it is recorded in provision for depreciation account. That's the difference. At the end of the financial year, transfer of depreciation, it will be transferred to P&L account. Profit and loss account debtor to depreciation account. The other entry will be same. Okay, then when an asset is sold, the reverse entry is going to come. Cash or bank account debtor to asset account. Suppose if you are selling for loss, it will be profit and loss account debtor for loss on sale. If it is a profit, you will put two P&L account. So cash account debtor, P&L account debtor to asset account if it is sold with the loss. Here, whenever asset is sold, you should close provision for depreciation account, because assets will appear at cost, or assets appears at cost. So whenever the asset is sold, this provision for depreciation should be closed. Simple. For example, you are having four machineries. You are selling one machinery, means provision for depreciation for that machine should be sold. That is closed. Other things are as usual. Cash or bank account debtor, profit and loss account debtor. Two asset account. Of course, the profit or loss account debtor will come if there is a loss on sale. So this provision for depreciation is nothing but accumulated depreciation. Accumulated depreciation on the asset sold. So whatever is accumulated depreciation on the asset sold, we will close it when we maintain what? Provision for depreciation account. So depreciation can be charged through normal method, asset to cash, depreciation to asset, P&L account debtor to depreciation. Then when you sell the asset, cash account debtor to asset account. When you are maintaining provision for depreciation account, depreciation goes to provision account. Then when the asset is sold, ensure that you are closing proportionate provision for depreciation. Copy this, pass and copy this. Before I proceed to the next concept, okay, there are certain useful terms which you have to learn. The word amortization is used for all tangible assets. Intangible assets like goodwill, trademark, patent right, copyright. Instead of the word depreciation, we use the word what? Amortization for all intangible assets. What do you mean by intangible assets? Which cannot be seen or touched, but there is a value. Goodwill, trademark, patent right, copyright. We use the word what? Amortization. Depletion is the word that is used for all natural resources like mines, oils, quarries, etc. Obsolescence is used for that whenever there is a loss in the value of asset due to technology. Whenever there is a loss in the value of asset due to change in the technology, we use the word which one? Obsolescence. Dilapidation is the word that we use for an asset which has been used for very long years, like 30 years, 40 years, like that. buildings or old machinery or building that is given for tenancy, all those things. Clear? So amortization is the word that is used for intangible assets. Depletion is the word used for natural resources. Obsolescence arises when there is a change in technology. Dilapidation happens, okay, when there is a very long term usage, when there is a very long term usage of asset, or because of time factor, we use the word dilapidation. Yeah, we had seen this reasons for calculating depreciation. Of course, first to find out cost of production, to calculate profit, okay, to show the fixed assets at fair value, to provide for replacement of asset. I told you depreciation is a secret reserve. It's a non-cash expense. Okay, it's a secret reserve. It is used for replacement of asset. Okay, to provide maintenance of capital and technological and legal requirements. Yes, the depreciation should be provided and allowed as per Income Tax Act and what? Companies Act. So this is the reason for claiming which one? Depreciation. Okay. We'll see some examples of calculating depreciation. Okay, the first method we call it as straight line method. We call it as what? Straight line method. Okay, I need not explain in detail because you know this already. Okay, so depreciation will be cost of the asset minus residual value divided by number of years. For example, first asset, cost means including installation expenses, 90,000 plus 10,000, 1 lakh. Minus residual value 20,000 divided by 8 years. So cost 1 lakh minus residual value 20,000 divided by 8 years. Second asset, 24,000 plus 7,000 will give us cost of the asset divided minus 3,100 divided by 6 years. 1 lakh 5,000 plus 20,000 minus 12,500 divided by 3 years. Next 2 lakh 50,000 plus 30,000 minus 56,000 scrap value divided by 5 years. This I have taken from your study material only. So cost of the asset minus scrap value divided by number of years. Okay, cost of the asset is 1 lakh, scrap value is 20,000 divided by number of years. So 1 lakh minus 20,000 divided by 8. 31,000 minus 3,100 divided by 6. 1,25,000 minus 12,500 by 5. You need not take up this one because it's there in your material. It's a very simple problem. You need not copy. 2,80,000 minus 56,000 divided by 10. Then how to calculate rate of depreciation? Simple. Depreciation amount divided by cost of the asset into 100. Depreciation amount divided by cost of the asset into 100. This 4,650 divided by 31,000 into 100. 22,500 divided by 1,25,000 into 100. 22,400 divided by 2,80,000 into 100. We get the percentage. Go to the next question. Machine is purchased for 7 lakhs, expense incurred is 3 lakhs. Calculate depreciation at 20% under SLM for the year ending 31st March 2014. Okay, don't go through the solution, you can directly work out. 7 lakhs plus 3 lakhs, cost of the asset becomes 10 lakhs. Depreciation rate is given 20% per annum. Year ends on 31st March 2014. Suppose if the asset is purchased on 1st April, 1st April to 31st March, full year it is used. So 3 lakhs plus 7 lakhs, 10 lakh into 20%, 2 lakhs. Don't see the solution. Directly we can do it here. 10 lakhs into 20%, 2 lakhs. Thus it is purchased on July 2013. 10 lakh into 20% into how many months? July to March. July to March, how many months? 9 months into 9 by 12. 10 lakh into 20% into 9 by 12. Next, if it is purchased in October, 10 lakh into 20% into 6 by 12. October to March, 6 months. If it is purchased in January, it is only 3 months. 10 lakhs into 20% into 3 by 12. Like that, we work out depreciation. So we can see the answers also. Right? If it is purchased on 1st July, 10 lakh 20% for 9 months. first October, 10 lakh 20% for 6 months, 10 lakh 20% for 3 months. This also you need not copy. Next, WDV method. We know the depreciation is calculated based on what? Opening balance of the asset. Okay, we purchased on 1st January for 10 lakhs, installation 50,000. So cost of the asset becomes 1,50,000. Depreciation is 10% reducing balance method. Depreciation up to 2013 they ask for. So what is the cost of the asset? 1,50,000. First year 10%, 15,000. So closing value will become 1,50,000 minus 10%, 1,35,000. So this will become opening book value for next year. On this 10% will be applied, 13,500, 1,21,500. So 1,21,500 into 10%, 12,150. So 1,09,350. So it's like depreciation is charged on the opening book value of the asset, that is value at the beginning of each year. So depreciation you can find, it comes down every year. Next, sum of units method is not practically used, but in costing we use this method. Simple, depreciation is nothing but production during the year divided by estimated production. Okay, cost minus scrap value. Please note, that is not written here. Cost minus scrap value into production for the current year divided by estimated total production. Go to this. Purchased for 60 lakhs. Life is 10 years. Residual value is 4 lakhs. Expected production is 2 lakhs. That is total life. 10 years. Okay. So depreciation for the first and second year, third and 30 to 6 years, 7 to 10 years will be based on those units of production. Okay, now to calculate depreciation. 60 lakhs minus 4 lakhs will give us depreciable amount. 60 lakhs minus 4 lakhs will give us depreciable amount into current year production divided by total production. So if you look at first and second year, 20,000, that is production for the current year, divided by estimated total production, 2 lakhs. Estimated total production is what? 2 lakhs into cost minus scrap value. 3 to 6 years. Okay. Current year production divided by estimated production into cost minus scrap value. Current year production divided by estimated production into cost minus scrap value. This will give us what? The depreciation for different years. 5,60,000 per annum, 4,20,000 per annum, and what? 7 lakhs per annum, like that. This will give us what? Depreciation. Go through the first problem. I request you to pause this lecture or video. Go through this first problem, then we will solve. ICMA study material problems, you have solutions. Okay, you can go through that directly. Okay. We will solve our own material problems. These problems are based on the past examination questions. So we are given on 1486, 11086, 1786, 87. Three machines are purchased. On 1188, one third of the machine which was purchased on 1486 became obsolete and sold for 6,000. The machinery was appreciated by fixed installment method, means original cost method. They ask you to prepare or show how the machinery account will appear in the ledgers 86, 87, 88. Assume that ledgers are closed on 31st December every year. Why can't you try? Pause the video and try. You have knowledge of depreciation from your plus 1, plus 2 level. Okay, why can't you try to prepare ledger accounts? Try to do it on your own, then check the answer. These answers are given. Hints are also given, available. I request you to try on your own before you proceed further. Must you try. The concepts which are known to you already, you can try, nothing wrong in it. This is normal method, not provision for depreciation account method. Hope you tried on your own, then you are coming here. Otherwise, work out the solution, then try to come. So when the first machinery was purchased? 1st April 86. Machinery account data to bank account. Machinery account data to bank account, how much? 60,000. Again, in the same year we are purchasing, 1/10/86. For 40,000. Yes, two machineries have purchased. At the end of the year, that is on 31st December 86, by depreciation we will provide for the first machinery how much? 60,000 into, what is the rate of depreciation? 60,000 into 10%, 6,000. For the second machinery, 40,000 into 10% into 6/12, how much it will be? 2,000. So total depreciation will be 8,000. Then you can close the balance of assets, 31/12/86. By balance carried down. Next year, 1/4, you can do or you can check your answers now. 1/4/87. If you feel that I am very slow, you can forward and copy. You can play in a 2x speed, 3x speed, that option is available. So this balance, 92,000, will come. I hope I am making a mistake. This is purchased on 1st April into 9/12. Into 9/12. How much? 4,000. This is purchased only in October month, so 3 months. 1,000. 5,000. This will become 95,000. We are buying on 1/7/87 to bank account. We are buying the next machine for how much? 20,000. Now on 31/12/87, by depreciation will be, first and second machine is there with me. The depreciation will continue, but not for 9 months, for the whole year. First machine, second machine is also used for the whole year. Okay, so it will be like 6,000, 4,000. And third machine is just purchased now. 20,000 into 10% into 6/12. So 11,000 is the depreciation. in India 88. Is there any purchase of machine? No. But we are selling one third of machine. We are selling only one third of the first machine, not full 60,000. Only one third of the machine is sold. Let us calculate. Only one third of the first machine, the value will be 20,000. Right? Then this has to be depreciated for how many years? Okay, 2 years. Depreciation for 86 for this portion to calculate profit or loss. This into 10% into 9 by 12. First year it is used only for 9 months. Less depreciation. This is under a straight line method. So this will be 20,000 into 10%. So first year for 9 months, second year for full, then value. This will give us book value on the date of sale, that is on 1488. Book value on 1488 will be 20,000 minus depreciation for the first year and depreciation for the second year. It is sold for how much? 6,000. So there is a loss on sale. Loss on sale is nothing but book value minus selling price. So how this will be recorded? Look at the journal entry. When the asset is sold, bank account data or P&L account data to asset account. So this will come as, hope you copied this. One third of the first machine, first year 9 months, second year for the whole year, book value 16,500. This is 16,500. Sold for 6,000 means loss on sale is 10,500. How to post this? By bank account for the sale, it is sold for 6,000. By profit and loss account. By profit and loss account, the balance will be that 10,500, loss on sale 10,500 transferred. Then 31,12, there is no purchase in this year, 31,12,88. Okay, we have to calculate depreciation. 31,12,88 by depreciation. Okay, first machine, 60,000 will not be there. One third is sold, so 40,000 will be there. Second machine is there and third machine is also there. So first machine, one third is sold, balance two third. Second machine, third machine for the whole year, 2,000. So add up the depreciation for this year is 10,000. Then you can close this. There is no purchase made. So buy balance carry down. Buy balance carry down is nothing but this minus sum of the credit items. Your total mistake 4,500. Yeah, this is 5,500. This will become 94,500. Please make a change. I made a mistake. Because in the regular class, you know, somebody will be there to correct me. But here, nobody is there. hope it is correct now. First year, there is a mistake I made. First year, I made a mistake. This 4,500, 1,000, 5,500 calculation errors. Yeah. The other years, it is correct. In the third year, out of the first machine, 1/3 is sold, balance 2/3 is there. 2/3 of the first machine. So closing balance is 77,000. Go to the question number 2. After 50,000 was provided as depreciation for the current year, the accumulated provision went up to 50,000. The machinery whose original cost has been 55,000 was sold for 20,000. Thereafter, they are replacing with the machinery for 75,000. They ask you to pass a journal entry. They ask you to pass what? Journal entry only. This is under provision for depreciation account method. They have given accumulated depreciation. This is nothing but provision for depreciation. So journal entry should be passed for current year depreciation and for selling the asset, then purchasing the new asset. You have to pass the journal entry. Try. So if you pass the journal entry, depreciation account data to provision for depreciation account 5,000. That is for the current year depreciation. P&L account data to provision for depreciation 5,000. Or depreciation 5,000. When an asset is sold, provision for depreciation account data are accumulated depreciation on the asset sold 50,000. What is the cost of the asset given in the problem? What is the cost of the asset given in the problem? Cost is 55,000. And it is sold for how much? 20,000. It is sold for 20,000. The balancing for will be profit on sale. The balancing for will be profit on sale 15,000. Profit on sale is transferred to which account? P&L account. So close the provision for depreciation, balancing figure transferred to which account? P&L account. Then for the new asset purchased, asset account data to cash or bank account 75,000. This will be the last entry or next entry. Here depreciation account data to provision for depreciation 5,000. P&L account data to depreciation transfer this. Close the provision for depreciation. Cash or bank account data for the sale. To asset account being the cost of the asset sold. This is nothing but cost of the asset sold. Because whenever we are maintaining provision for depreciation, the asset is recorded at cost 55,000. P&L account balancing for is 15,000. P&L account balancing for us 15,000 loss on sale. Then these are the three entries we pass for depreciation and sale. Then for the purchase of asset, asset account data to cash or bank account. Next question number 3. I request you to try this problem at home. Okay. I will cover the solution in the next part. I will cover the solution of question number 3. This is under a WDV method. WDV method, written down value method. I request you to try this problem. Okay, solution I will provide along with the next lecture. Okay, but you must try this problem. Question number 3. Okay, after this, the next lecture I will cover change in the method of depreciation also. Straight line method to WDV method, WDV method to SLM. Change in the method of depreciation I will cover in the next lecture. Okay, please try question number 3.